A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 3rd October, on the front page you have Prime Minister Modi declares country open defecation free. So this is on the anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. On 2nd October, Prime Minister has declared the country open defecation free, claiming success of the government's initiative under which every household now apparently has access to toilets. So here you can see the further detail provided. Prime Minister pressed a remote unveiling the map of India as open defecation free at Sabarmati riverfront ground in the presence of more than 2 lakh village heads from across the country. So he said this is a great initiative in achievement of the Swachh Bharat movement, which has people's participation. Then here you have US warns partners of sanctions risks. So this is when External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar said that he was reasonably convinced of persuading US to accept India's decision on the purchase of Russian S-400 missile defense system. US officials on the same day warned that any such purchase might risk sanctions. We are planning to buy this S-400 missile defense system. It has been in news for long. Again, it has resurfaced in news. So this is the advanced missile defense system which India is buying. Other countries have also brought it. Turkey has brought it. So USA is not happy with it. USA says that if you are going to buy Russian arms and, you know, this Russian missile, then we are going to have sanctions triggered, because USA has passed this act called Countering American Adversaries Through Sanctions Act, CATSA. So under it, anybody having, you know, such transactions with Russia will have to face sanctions. So India has also been warned about it. Then this is bank account norms likely to be reviewed. So this is following the hardships faced by customers in opening bank accounts. Government will now review norms for the same. So top bankers have highlighted the problems at meeting with finance minister. And now the rules mandating proof of current address to open an account. So this, as such, customers have to submit any of the 6 officially valid documents in proof of the address. So 6 documents are voter ID, passport, driver's license, letter issued by National Population Register, NREGA job cards and Aadhaar. So bankers said this caused major problems, that there are many instances when people are unable to open account after shifting from a city or locality, because she could not change his address in the documents. Then below you have opaque censorship leaves Twitter users chafing. So this is Indian legal demands for content removal, which are said to be the 4th highest in the world, which has caused problems. Here you can see the number of content removal demands by government agencies and law enforcement units over the years and how they have increased significantly now. So this is it. And below you have Pakistan national moves high court for children's school admission. So this is a Pakistani national who says he has migrated to India along with his family in May 2019, and he's seeking admission in Delhi government school, in a government school in Delhi, but his children have been refused admission and he has approached the high court now. He says that when Pakistani Hindus come to India, they have been given admissions, even special consideration has been given on been referred to by then External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj. The rules are relaxed and they are given admission, but for his children, 3 children and in different age group, when they are seeking admission, it is being denied. He says that he's been persecuted in Pakistan and that's why he has left the country. And his application for Indian citizenship is under consideration by the center. On page 3, you have shoppers welcome plastic ban in Delhi Haj due lack of alternatives. So people are not allowed to carry bags of chips or biscuits that come in plastic wrappers too. So Delhi government has banned single-use plastic at all 3 Delhi Hearts and the Garden of 5 Senses in Saket under nationwide campaign Swachhta Hi Seva. So this is now a good initiative, but what is lacking is alternatives to plastic. And below you have CM endorses clean air declaration at C40 summit. So Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal will be among 20 leaders from mega cities across the world to launch the clean air cities declaration. So it's a set of short and long term commitments towards cleaning the air. So this will be at the C40 summit in Copenhagen. So it's going to take place on October 11. So C40 summit is a network of world's mega cities committed to addressing climate change. So this is, then on page 6 you have manual scavenging still a grim reality in MP's Shivpuri. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi has declared the country open defecation free, but sanitation workers continue to clean sewers, and the concern is that they do it without protective care. We have seen many such instances of how sanitation workers have lost their lives when they jump into sewer tanks to clean them without any protective gear. So the gas which is released in the sewer is life-threatening. So that's a cause of concern. Plus also the Safai Karmcharis are from a particular lower caste. So the caste link is also there here. So it's like a job linked to lower castes, so that is also a cause of concern. So Safai Karmcharis, they have to be given protective care, and this linking to caste aspect also has to be eliminated. Then below you have cement firm to use plastic waste for fuel in Meghalaya. So Meghalaya government have began battling plastic waste in 2018 by building first road with it in Nongstoin town. So now Meghalaya government has signed an agreement with major cement firm for buying plastic waste to be used as fuel instead of coal for producing clinkers. Then on page 8 you have India hails UK verdict on former Nizam. So this is regarding former Nizam of Hyderabad, the 7th Nizam of Hyderabad, Osman Ali Khan. So there is this case going on in UK High Court on which ruling has come now. It's a very old case. It's a case of 1948. So the UK High Court presently has given its ruling in which India and the descendants of the 7th Nizam have been entitled to the have won, and the court has ruled that descendants are entitled to £35 million fund of the Nizam. And Pakistan, which had counterclaims here, its claims have been rejected. So it's a 71-year-old case, as you can see, dating back to 1948. And here you can see the details as such too given. So the case relates to this transfer of fund, around £35 million and 9 shillings by the Nizam's envoy and foreign minister in London on September 16, 1948 to Pakistan. So when Indian Army's tanks were closing in on Hyderabad from all directions, the Nawaz, Mohammad Nawaz Jung, who was the foreign minister of the Nizam, he transferred the money to the account of Habib Ibrahim Rahmatullah, the High Commissioner of Pakistan in London. So this amount transfer, as such is in question. It is said that Hyderabad's armed forces had already surrendered to the General J.N. Chaudhary in September 1948 after military operations known as Operation Polo. So within days of the surrender, Nizam sent a message to National Westminster Bank demanding that the money be transferred back to his account. But Pakistan started claiming the money. So this case has been going on in UK court, and now finally you can see the ruling has come and his descendants have been entitled to this money. Then on page 9 you have excess rain washes out IMD's method. So Indian Meteorological Department's new dynamic model has failed to forecast August and September deluge. So questions are being raised now. So India this year may have recorded its highest monsoon in 25 years. So this new monsoon model called Monsoon Mission Coupled Forecast Model, deployed by the Indian Meteorological Department over the last decade, don't do better than the older ones in long-range forecasting, is what has become evident now. On the editorial page, the first editorial is a sound review. So this is regarding Supreme Court's order on anti-atrocities law. It is a caution against entering legislative domain. So Supreme Court actually had ruled on diluting scheduled castes and scheduled tribes prevention of atrocities and the anti-atrocities law, But then there were protests and government had to amend the law, and now Supreme Court has also revoked its order. So this article, this editorial says that Supreme Court had actually entered into legislative domain. So legislation was modified through Supreme Court order. So this is a caution against such practice in future. And this is reigning misery. So it says better infrastructure for water management to break the droughts and flood cycle is needed. So sometimes India is facing droughts and other times India is facing floods. So this is a cycle which needs to be broken, and infrastructure, better infrastructure for water management is what is required. And then here you have the lead article, Decoding the Corporate Hindutva Alliance. So it says it spells out double danger, threatening India's secular and democratic standing and miring the economy deeper in crisis. So how, you know, Hindutva nationalism is being used, and you know, corporates allies are being made, and it is affecting the economy of the country as such. Then this is furthering this neighborhood friendship. So this is regarding India-Bangladesh relations. The article says there is scope for India-Bangladesh ties to move to the next level based on cooperation, coordination and consolidation. So there are various issues between the two countries too. The Rohingya refugees issue. Bangladesh has the largest refugee camp for Rohingya refugees in Cox's Bazar. And India also has a refugee problem with respect to Rohingyas. So how the two countries coordinate on that is also discussed here, along with other aspects of relation like the trade relation between the two countries, and even, you know, the land routes, how land routes have gained popularity over air travel and are preferred for by Bangladeshis to visit India. So all that is covered. Then there is also Teesta River, which is a cause of concern between the two countries, river water sharing. Then on the op-ed page you have, in pursuit of an ideal criminal process. So this article says that it is time to rethink the power of arrest and the concept of cognizable offense. So when cognizable offense is there, then a person may be arrested. So what is the power of arrest? You know, that is discussed here, and says that needs to be a rethink of an ideal criminal process. And this is miles to go before becoming open defecation free. So this article says that India needs to have non-coercive sanitation policy for those who continue to use the outdoors. So it cannot be a coercive policy, and it says there are still concerns that we are not completely open defecation. And this is regarding Tanzania, how authoritarianism is being seen emerging in Tanzania, which is just a reputation of democratic stability. On page 13, you have, amid outrage, senior political leaders set free in Jammu. So, National Conference, Congress, and you know, Jammu and Kashmir Party leaders have been let off with strictures on public statements regarding Article 370. So, they have been released, but there is no relief for valid detainees. Then, this is the Jammu and Kashmir High Court's panel, you know, which visited the juvenile house, courts as the observation homes in Srinagar and Jammu. It has said that there is no child kept or taken into illegal detention in Kashmir. So Juvenile Justice Act is strictly followed in arrests of juveniles in conflict with law. So this is what has been submitted by the High Court committee to Supreme Court. It is said total of 46 juveniles were detained, but then they were they were not illegally detained. Then on international page you have, Johnson offers Brexit compromise to EU. So Prime Minister Boris Johnson of UK has says that UK will leave the grouping by October 31 and promises that there won't be checks at the Irish border as well. So that is a major bone of contention on the Brexit deal, which should be acceptable to both the sides, that is Britain as well as EU. So UK has offered the European Union a proposed Brexit deal that is set to represent a compromise for both sides. So he has plans to hold rapid negotiations towards a solution after years of wrangling. is what the Prime Minister Boris Johnson has asked EU for. He sent a letter. Then this is anger mounts in Hong Kong after teen shot at. So Hong Kong office workers and high school students turned out in hundreds under sweltering midday sun to denounce a policeman for shooting and wounding a teenager during most violent clashes in nearly 4 months of unrest. He said more than 100 people have been wounded. Then the Taliban delegation on its way as US envoy holds talks in Pakistan. So now US has, the Taliban has announced that they are sending a high-level delegation to Pakistan, Islamabad, as part of a tour that has included Russia, China and Iran in a push to resurrect an Afghan peace deal with Washington that seems just, seemed imminent just months ago. So now Taliban talks have again been initiated. Earlier talks were taking place in Qatar. Now it is 11-member delegation has gone to Pakistan from Afghanistan, Taliban. Then on business page you have PMC suspended, MD says auditors did superficial job. So this is a suspended MD of Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank, Joy Thomas, who has blamed the auditors for the mess at the bank, accusing them of only superficially auditing the books of the now crippled lender due to time constraints. So this is it. And below you have cutting off power in an accident is key in electric vehicles. So there's this Bosch device. So these devices prevent car occupants, rescuers from suffering electric shock. So that is said to be the key factor in electric vehicles. So these are tiny powerful devices, like if airbag sensor detects an impact, the tiny device measuring no more than 10 millimeter by 10 millimeter and weighing a few grams triggers the pyrofuse, and this sets a little explosion that drives a wedge into the high voltage cable between the battery unit and the power electronics, disconnecting the two. So flow of power is disconnected. So this will ensure that there is no risk of electric shock or fire. So lithium-ion batteries, the power source for electric vehicles, actually are flammable. But this is the technology which is said to be used in electric vehicles. So that is it. Then the last page has sports news. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aashara.com. Thank you.